Hello and welcome everyone. In this video, we are going to learn how to make helical gear using NX. Okay. Now, typically we have already completed the set of sweep commands and the sweep series itself. So in the previous videos, if you haven't watched those videos, I would recommend you to go and get a knowledge of sweep first and then try to follow along to create the helical gear because that will be easier. Okay. Now, I have noticed something that more than 60% of the viewer who are viewing the channel has not subscribed to the channel. So I would recommend you to please kindly, if you are watching the channel on a regular basis or if you are feeling these videos are helping you, please subscribe to the channel and please do share this set of videos with everyone. Now, before we start, one more request. I want you to comment in the comment section below that do you want my next video in Hindi or in English? Okay, because in the next video, I'm going to explain how to make this particular, let me open it. Okay, how to make this particular flower vase. Okay, so that is something which I'm going to explain in the next video. So you have to tell me whether you want my next video to be in English or in Hindi so that I can decide the preparation for the next video. Okay, and now on the comment today itself. So if you're watching this video today, so please do comment on the channel. Okay, how you want this this particular video to be in. Now let us start with the design of the helical gear, and that is not going to take much because we already know the capabilities of NX and the capability of sweep command typically of NX. Now I'll start with a sketch on the top plane. Okay, because let's say, or you can even create a sketch on the front plane. So let's say I'm creating a sketch on the front plane and I'm creating a circle from the origin of diameter 100. Okay, so I have created a circle here at the origin of diameter 100. Then I'm creating a horizontal line on the top. Okay, and I'm making sure the center point of the line, the midpoint of the line and the origin are in the same line. So they are vertically aligned, and then the distance from the line to the origin is going to be 85 mm, and the length of the line is going to be 15 mm. Then I'm creating an arc from this point till here. Okay, and this is what my arc is going to look like, and the radius of that arc is going to be 65. Now I'm going to mirror this arc. Okay, and make sure while mirroring, the curve rule is set to single curve so that the arc is only getting selected, and the center line will be my y-axis. So this is how I've mirrored my arc, and the distance from this bottom end point to this bottom end point is going to be 40. Okay, so here the basic shape is ready. Now I'll go to pattern command inside the sketch itself. Now here in pattern, I'm going to select connected curve. Okay, because I have not trimmed yet. So if I select connected curve, only this particular part is going to get selected. Now I want my pattern layout to be circular. In specify reference point, I'm going to select the origin or the center point of the circle. Okay, and then in number of copies, here in spacing, I want count and span. In number of copies, I want 6 copies. Okay, I want 6 copies, and the angle will be 360 degrees. Now if I click OK, this is how it's going to look like. Now I can go for the trim feature. Okay, I can activate the trim feature and then trim the remaining geometries. So this is my section for helical gear. So now I can click on finish, and this is how it's going to look like. And believe me, this is the last sketch, technically the second last sketch after the guide which we have created. Okay, now I'll go for a sketch on the top plane, and I know my sketch is over here, so I'll create a line like this. So if your sketch is oriented like this, so make sure you create a line like this, right? Okay, the length of this line is going to be 95 because that is what my helical gear length is going to be. Okay, so the length of this line is 95 and this is my helical gear. Now what I can do is I can go to the surface tab, then I can go to the sweep command. Here in section, I can choose connected curve and I can select this section, or I'll just reset this first before I do any selection. Connected curve, I'll select this section. Then here in guide, I'll select single curve, I'll select this line. Okay, now first thing I need to go step by step. Here I need to make sure preserve shape is on. Here it doesn't matter if you choose anything, because technically this will only be helpful if you have more than one section. But here, because we have only one section and one guide, this is not going to be helpful. Now in orientation, okay, in orientation I'm going to choose angular law. Okay, and here in place of constant, I'm going to choose linear. The starting angle will be 0, but the ending angle will be 30. So technically, this is how the helical gear is going to look like. So the ending angle over here is 30 degree. Now what I also want is, here in place of constant, I'm going to select a blending function. And here the start is going to be 1 and the end is going to be, suppose, 0.5. Okay, so this is how I want my helical gear to look like. So the ending is half the size of the starting, and this is how exactly the shape of this helical gear is going to look like. Okay, so now if I click OK, if you notice, this is how this particular helical gear has been created. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you understood, and make sure you comment in the comment section below that what type of language do you want me to use for the next video, for the upcoming video. And I wanted to know today so that tomorrow I can publish that video. And if you're new to the channel, kindly subscribe and follow along. Have a great day ahead. Thank you very much.